This is a course on economics. It means studying why and how people make the choices that they do. This certainly includes decisions to buy and sell goods, but it also includes how people choose careers, how they balance work and leisure, how they spend their time volunteering, and how they plan their future. This first unit is about what is seen and what is unseen. The title comes from the famous French economist Frédéric Bastiat. One of his most famous parables is called The Broken Window. In this story, a shop owner's window is broken by a street urchin. The shop owner is understandably upset by this. As he stands there considering his misfortune, he's comforted by others who say, "Look, some good will come of this destructive act. Yes, you will have to pay the glazier 6 francs to replace it, but if the glazier receives the 6 francs, then he may spend it buying new clothes from the tailor, who will in turn have more money to spend on shoes. This broken window will provide work and income to the entire village." The mistake, of course, is to focus only on the economic activity that is seen. But what about what is unseen? The shop owner is 6 francs poorer. If his window hadn't been broken, he may have used those 6 francs to purchase a book or a bushel of apples, thereby creating another stream of activity similar to the first case. The difference is that he would do this and still have a window. Henry Hazlitt, a follower of Bastiat, says, "The bad economist sees only what immediately strikes the eye. The good economist also looks beyond. The bad economist sees only the direct consequences of a proposed course. The good economist looks also at the longer and indirect consequences. The bad economist sees only what the effect of a given policy has been or will be on one particular group. The good economist inquires also what the effect of the policy will be on all groups." This first unit is also about how prices send signals. Through prices, the needs and desires of billions of people are conveyed to millions of businesses. Prices help them decide what to produce, when and where to produce it, and how much to produce. If prices are not allowed to fluctuate freely, they cease to be helpful signals. Companies and individuals cannot make good choices without prices. Imagine going to the grocery store and only finding out the price of items after you bought them. But besides transmitting information, prices create incentives. They encourage people to buy relatively abundant goods and to economize on scarce goods. They also encourage companies to produce scarce goods that have high prices and to cut back on the production of abundant goods that have low prices. Market forces working through the price mechanism are the essence of Adam Smith's invisible hand process. Friedrich Hayek, another famous economist who you'll be studying, called this price system a marvel. This course will show you why.